see now, we saw about this happiness survey, right, which was organized by Outlook and Club Mahindra as far as India is concerned. So loneliness and boredom among people also are great problems for people today. Why people are unhappy? Because of loneliness and boredom. Okay. So to beat this loneliness and boredom, in the modern world, we have created so many different ways by which we can beat this boredom. Like, say, for instance, in Japan, they've created artificial beaches. Why would people in Japan create artificial beaches? Japan is a country, it's an island country. It's fully surrounded by the ocean. It is something where you can even artificially control the temperature of the beach. The sand particles are all artificial globules, which give a feel of the original sand, but they don't stick to the body, like unlike the real sand. So, you know, some kind of improvisation they think. And the clouds are artificially created. The exposure of the sun is controlled, and the waves are thermally automated to suit the requirement of the crowd, right? In the beginning, people were very excited. People used to flock to these artificial beaches. But then, within 3-4 years, the market of the artificial beaches plummeted like anything. People were not going. Many of the artificial beaches were shut down. Majority of the theme parks across the globe are not able to generate sufficient profits to sustain themselves. In our day-to-day activities, we find so many examples where people choose to spend their free time engaging themselves with gadgets or video games rather than taking advantage and seeking pleasure in naturally available forms of entertainment. So this is the temporary happiness that we experience in the temporary world. Any day, artificial and expensive entertainment is lower taste when compared to natural entertainment that is available. So you see, make-believe can't really make one happy, truly. Real stuff gives real happiness. Make-believe, like artificial entertainment, artificial beaches, they don't really give enjoyment for a long time. You have a bird inside the cage, and if you keep polishing the cage alone, what will happen to the bird? You don't feed the bird. You're only taking care of the cage. What will happen over a period of time? The bird will die over a period of time. So that is what it is. Our body is like the cage, which is a bird. The soul, yes, that's the real you. If you don't feed the soul and only keep taking care of the body, you bathe the body, clothe the body, feed the body, all of these things, the soul will it'll cry for a period of time and then it'll die. That's called the death of the soul, spiritual death. Okay, so yes. So you see, I can't stand being bored. It's not right. It's not fair. You don't deserve it. You really don't deserve it. But the soul is full of vibrancy and constantly intensifying newness. Nava nava rasa dhamani udyatum rantumasi. The soul wants to experience newer and newer things. Actually, the soul is full of newness because it's full of eternity. And for the soul to interact with the material world, the soul has to make believe. Okay, the soul has to make believe. Make believe he's some 18-year-old guy with his first driver's license. Make believe he's some proud new grandpa. Make believe he's the body, right? So unless we make believe, you cannot really enjoy the body in this world. You will have to make believe. But then that alone, of course, you'll have to bathe the body, clothe the body, feed the body. But we cannot stop with that. Of course, you'll have to take care of the cage. But you cannot stop with that. You've got to feed the bird in the cage as well.